I don't think that's what this moment is about. And I feel like this shouldn't be confused with that movement. Everybody has, you know, should be able to tell their story, but it doesn't necessarily have to be linked to this movement.
Like, even some women are like, oh, guys, there's a difference between a bad date and whatever. It's like, how many of us have been on that date before? And at the end of the day, like, coercion is not okay.
I think the Aziz Ansari story is kind of a step backwards a little bit, but broadening the topic and diversifying the conversation into that it's not always so black and white. There is a large gray area. I think that more people are now talking and asking more questions about, like, what is right and what is wrong.
We definitely need a proper definition of what sexual assault is. I think the media and so many people are asking women to be these, like, superheroes all the time when, like, wouldn't it just be so much easier to ask men to just be, like, normal, nice, considerate people?
Men should realize that we don't really like to be pressured into having this. If we say no once, it should be enough.
Classifying something like that as sexual assault can take away from, like, the movement as a whole.
I think that story is about men not understanding what women want and need when having sex. He was very aggressive with her and didn't read the cues. But it's not on the same level as Harvey Weinstein or any of those guys. It's bad. I'm so sorry for the woman. It's a terrible experience. Most of us have had it.
To have reporters say things like, she's ruining his career for a bad date, is completely and utterly against what we're fighting for with Me Too.